Hello children, I welcome you back again to our history session. Lesson number 1, what, where, how and when. So children, in the last session we have seen what is history, okay? History, as I already told you, history is the nothing but it is a story of the past. Like in this lesson we are going to see the story of the early man. Like now you can see this pictures, okay, modern man and early man. Last session only I have told you the relation between these two, okay. So actually we as a modern man, we used to be like that. This picture you can see, it is the stages of early man, okay. So this history, it shows us the evolution of man, how we have evolved from years, million and million years ago. So by showing you a small video, children, you can understand the concept more clearly. Now I am going to show you the video.
Thank you.
So children, these were the four stages of early humans. Just now what you have watched the video. So thus, this is how history helps us to find out about the past. So same way, in the last session we have studied about the purpose of studying history. As it is history, it is derived from the word enquiry. It tells about the story of past, so it is called as history. Again, this lesson we will learn about the eating habits of the early people, the kinds of clothes they used to wear, the types of houses they live, and this it also tells you about the lives of hunters, herders, farmers, rulers, scientists, musicians, etc. Again, in the last lesson we have seen the activities or the occupations of early humans, like many year, like people near about 100,000 years, people used to live along the banks of river Narmada, and some of them were skilled gatherers. They used to collect the food from various fruits, forest products like roots and fruits, etc. They also started hunting animals. They had a vast wealth of plants in the surrounding forest. Here in this picture, here map, you can see Narmada. Okay, here see children, here it is Narmada river. So here the people used to live on the banks of river Narmada over 100,000 years ago. Again, how the development took place? Slowly and gradually, people started developing agriculture. People in Suleiman and Kirtar were the first areas where man and woman cultivated wheat and barley. So here is the place Suleiman and Kirtan. Okay, so here where the people first found wheat and barley. Again, they started rearing the animals like goat and sheep and lived in villages. Afterwards, rice was the first grown in Garo hills of Vindhyas. Okay, here you can see Vindhya. So here first cultivation of rice was first started. Again, near about 4700 years ago, some earliest cities like Harappa and Mohenjo-daro, etc., they flourished on the bank of this Indus river. 2500 years ago, cities developed on the banks of Ganga and tributaries, and Magad was the first important city situated on river Ganga. Afterwards, people started traveling in search of food along the deserts, rivers, seas and hills, and also to escape from the natural calamities, they conquered new areas, preached religious ideas, and also many religious teachers, they started walking from place to place to offer their instructions, advices. Like for example, Xuanzang, he came to China in 630 AD to learn Buddhism. Also Alexander the Great invaded India. Then again we have seen how our country got the name as India, that is Bharat or India. Like for example, how India comes from Indus, called Sindhu in Sanskrit. Many Iranians or Greeks came to India near about 2500 years ago, and they were familiar with this river Indus, so they used to call it as Hindus or Indos. And Bharat, it was used for group of people living northwest in subcontinent. Now we will see how different sources of finding the past, like there were three sources, as I have already told you: manuscript, inscription and archaeological sites. So what is just we will have a brief. What is manuscript? It is a word, Latin word manu, which means hand, and it was mostly written on the palm leaf or bark of the tree called as birch. But many times it used to get destroyed due to the natural factors, like it was eaten by the insects, etc. But though it was also preserved in temples or monasteries, and mostly these books, they dealt with all kinds of subjects like medicines or the lives of kings, epics, poems, etc. And it was mostly written in Sanskrit or Prakrit language. Again, we have seen last time about inscription. Inscriptions were mostly they were written on hard surface, okay, like walls, stones or metals, and most of the kings could got their orders inscribed so that people could read it, obey it properly. Kings often kept them as records of victories in their battles. The last source of last sources, archaeological sources, many monuments, fossils, these are fossils, okay. So, many monuments, fossils, sculptures are among the archaeological sources, and the person who studies these sources are called as archaeologist. Then again, they study the remains of buildings, stones, bricks, paintings, even they go at burial site and they study the dead bodies of humans. And they also look for the bones of animals and birds and find out actually what the people ate in the past. And one more important thing is, historians are the scholars who study the past by using these three sources, means manuscript, inscription and archaeological sources. By using these three sources, the historians, they study about the past. Now, next topic we saw was one past or many, means actually past was not same for everyone. It was even in the past, it was different for different types of people. Like for example, lives of herders and farmers, it was different from kings and queens. Even today you can see people in Andaman Nicobar Islands, they get their food by fishing, hunting, collecting forest products, while people in the cities, they depend on others for their supplies. Again, in the olden days, kings could keep the records of their battle, but ordinary people could not keep the records. Why? Because they were unable to write. Even they may not be having that sources to write. One more topic last time we took, that was the importance of dates. As why dates are important, why dates are so much important in history. So dates play an important role in history. They were expressed as AD or BC. Years before the birth of Jesus Christ was called as BC, that is before Christ, and they are counted backwards. Again, the year after the birth of Jesus Christ was called as AD, that is Anno Domini. It is counted forward. So in this lessons, we will refer to dates going back from the present using 2000 as our starting point. So now children, we will go through the textbook. I would request you to please open your textbook, take pencil in your hand and keep notebook also ready with you. We are going to read the lesson. Okay children, now open your textbook. Lesson number 1 is what, where, how and when. Okay, so you can see here the picture of a girl, right? Her name is Rashida. Okay, so what she is saying, just see Rashida's question. There is a question arising in her mind. Rashida sat reading the newspaper. Okay, suddenly her eyes fell on a small headline. Now what was the headline? Just see, 100 years ago. How, she wondered, could anyone know what happened so many years ago? So here is the question of Rashida, that as she was reading the newspaper, her eyes fell on the small headline mentioning that 100 years ago. So she was very surprised, she was very wondered, how anyone can tell about such things that have happened over 100 years ago. So children, now we will come to next topic, finding out what happened. So can you tell me if something has happened yesterday, how you will remember? Will you remember what has happened yesterday? Yes, you will remember. Just even if you don't remember, what you will do? You will ask your parents, okay, or you will ask your friends. Suppose if you have not come school yesterday, then what you are going to do? You will ask your friends, no? What happened yesterday in the class? What has teacher taught us? Like this. But again, if something you want to know about your country, about your area, about your city, then where you will go? So you will go to newspaper, right? You will, or otherwise you will watch the news of the TV channel. So by watching TVs, news, by listening radios or by reading the newspaper, we can come to know what has happened yesterday. Again, last year, if last year you want to remind something, then how you will get what happened last year? So that by asking someone who remembers, that we can find out what has happened last year. But what has happened long, long year ago, who can tell us? Can your parents will be able to tell us, or your friends will be able to tell you what has happened long year ago? No, we will not remember actually what has happened so many years ago. So who will help you to find out all this? So to find out all these answers, our history is going to help us. So let us see how it can be done. What can we know about past? Okay, what can we know? We want to study about the past, but what can we know about the past? Means there are several things which we can know about the past. Like there are several things we can find out: what people ate in the early days, okay, the kinds of clothes they wore, the houses in which they lived. We can find out about the lives of hunters, herders, farmers, rulers, merchants, priests, craft persons. Craft persons means blacksmith, ironsmith, goldsmith, okay. Again, artists, musicians and scientists. Means we can know so much things about these persons from past. We can also find out about the games children used to play in the olden days. Again, the stories they heard, the place they saw, and the song they sang. Now next question comes to our mind is, where did people live? Okay, now we have seen what were the different types of people who used to live. Now where did they live? So as I have shown you on the slides, river Narmada. Okay, so even in your book you can take out the next page, find the river Narmada on page 1. Sorry, on map 1, page 2. People have lived along the banks of this river for several hundred thousand years ago. So means on the river, on the banks of river Narmada, several thousand years ago, people used to live there. And these people, some of them were skilled hunt gatherers. Gatherers means the people who used to collect the roots of the fruits. Okay. So they were skilled gatherers. That is people who gathered their food. They knew about the vast wealth of plants in the surroundings. Okay, they had a good idea, good knowledge about these plants and the forest. They collected the fruits, roots and other forest produce for their food. They also, now again, in the side by side, they used to collect the forest product also, plus they used to hunt the animals also. Now here on the map, find the Suleiman and Kirtar hills to the northwest. So here you have to just mark these two places, okay, with pencil. Suleiman and Kirtar, they are on the northwest. Some of the areas where women and men first began to grow crops such as wheat and barley about 8000 years ago. So these were the areas where women and men first they started growing barley and wheat near about 8000 years ago. People also began rearing animals like sheep, goat and cattle, and they started living in villages. So these now again locate the Garo hills to the northeast and the Vindhyas in the central India. So here you can see Vindhyas, okay, in central India, and just mark this point Vindhya and again mark this point Garo hills. Okay, so these were some of other areas where agriculture developed. Okay, so agriculture also developed in Garo hills and Vindhyas. The place where rice was first grown are to the north of Vindhya. So here in Vindhyas first the rice was cultivated. Again, next one is trace the river Indus and its tributaries. So just see, where is river Indus? Come on, find out. See children, here is river Indus. Okay, here is river Indus and these are the tributaries. Like the tributaries are Jhelum, Ravi and Chambal. The river Indus and its tributaries are smaller rivers. Tributaries means they are the smaller rivers that flow into a larger river. So about 4700 years ago, Some of the earlier cities flourished on the banks of these rivers. So near about 4700 years ago, many few cities, they flourished like anything, like I have told you Mohenjo-daro it flourished like anything on the bank of rivers. Later, about 2500 years ago, cities developed on the banks of Ganga and its tributaries and along the sea coast. Now, look at the Ganga and its tributaries called the Sun. So, here again on the map we can see Ganga river and its tributaries, okay. In ancient times, the area along these rivers to the south of Ganga was known as Magad, now lying in the state of Bihar. Its rulers were very powerful and they set up a large kingdom. Kingdoms were set up in other parts of the country as well. So this Magad, it was like it became an important city on the river Ganga, okay, and now it is lying in the state Bihar. So kingdoms in this state, they were set up in other parts of the country as well. Throughout, people traveled from one part to other of other subcontinent. Throughout people traveled from one part of the subcontinent to another. The hills and the high mountains, including the Himalayas, deserts, rivers and seas, made journey dangerous at times, but never impossible. Means these people, they started traveling from one place to another, like Himalayas, deserts, rivers and seas, but though the journey was so dangerous, but they have never stopped their journey. So men and women moved in search of livelihood, as also to escape from natural disasters like floods or droughts. So even they started moving by also because of this natural disasters like floods or droughts. Sometimes men marched in armies, conquering other lands. Besides merchants, they travelled with caravans or ships carrying valuable goods from place to place. And religious teachers, they walked from village to village, town to town, stopping to offer instructions and advice on the way. Means many at that time, some people, they started traveling with caravans or ships carrying the valuable goods and exchanging them. Again, some persons, they marched in armies, and others, they became religious teachers, and they walked from village to village, town to town, giving their instructions and advices to the people. And all this led to the sharing of ideas between the people. Why do people travel nowadays? Nowadays, why do we travel, children? We travel for some work, for some business, okay, or to meet our relatives, friends. Look at map 1 once more. Hills, mountains and seas from the natural frontiers of the subcontinent. While it was difficult to cross these frontiers, those who wanted could and did scale the mountains and cross the seas. Though it was difficult, but still the people who wanted, they started crossing the mountains and the seas. People from across the frontiers also came into this subcontinent and settled here. So these movements of people, it enriched our cultural traditions. Okay, they started moving from one place to another, they started settling at one place. So all these led movements of people, it enriched our traditional cultural traditions. People have shared new ways of carving stone, composing music and even cooking food over several hundreds of years. Okay, so now we have seen where did the people live, and now we are going to see the names of the land, means how our country got the name as India or Bharat. Two of the words we often use for our country are India and Bharat. Okay, the word India, it comes from the Indus, called Sindhu in Sanskrit. So the word India itself, it comes from a Sanskrit word, that is the name of the river called Sindhu. Okay, now find Iran and Greece in your atlas. You must be having atlas, okay. In that you find where is the place Iran and Greece. The Iranians and the Greece who came through the northwest about 2000. Okay, the Iranians and the Greeks who came through the northwest about 2500 years ago and were familiar with in the Indus called it Hindus or Indus. Okay, the Iranians and the Greeks, those who came from the northwest, they were familiar with this river Indus, and that's why they used to call it as Hindus or Indus. And like that, the name of our country, it came to be spelled as India, and the land to the called it Indus or Indus, and the land to the east of the river was called as India. The name Bharat was used for the group of people who lived in the northwest and who are mentioned in the Rig Veda, the earliest composition in Sanskrit, that is dated to about 3500 years ago, and later it was used for the country. So now you have seen how our country got the name as India and Bharat. Okay, so children, today we will today this much only we will learn, and our next session we will be continuing. So here I'll conclude my session, and have a good day children. Next time bring again sit with your books, textbook, notebook and pencil. We are going to complete the lesson and we are going to do the exercises. Okay, thank you. Have a good day.